Hey, what's up, my friend? Kris Krohn here, and today I'm going to be talking about the secret of wealth and happiness. Is there a secret? And if there is, what is it? Can I shave a decade or two off of your life experience? I think in this short video, I can. You know, we talk about where happiness comes from, and let's be honest. If you take a look at what people spend money on, and if you take a look at where people's time commitment is in their calendar, that pretty much tells you where people's priorities are in life. And right now, for most of us, we're so busy trying to get ahead. Some of us are playing the game of keeping up with the Joneses. Some of us don't want to admit it, but it's actually kind of true. And there's this hope and this idea that if I have money, and I have a nicer house, or I have more travel, or if I have nicer cars, will that bring me the happiness? Today, I want to share a little bit of my personal journey of what I've learned about wealth and what I've learned about happiness. And I believe I can help you learn how to be a heck of a lot happier today than you might actually be. So listen up, school is in session. So I had an experience where when I was poor financially and I knew that I was going to make it through real estate and I had done my first deal, I knew that I needed more deals to get me where I wanted to be. And at the time, I was really driven by feeling like it was the world against me. College wasn't going to give me the degree that I wanted. They said I was too stupid to get the right grade in the sciences. My mother-in-law is going to kill me if I don't get a degree. My wife and I are just trying to figure out how to be happy and figure out life and what its meaning is for us. And I really felt lost. I wanted to get where I wanted to be a lot faster. I wanted to be free. And I thought if I was free from a job, I'm going to be a lot happier. So something weird happened when I fast forward 4.5 years. I bought my 25th home. I had a residual income of $12,000 a month. I woke up that morning. I asked my wife, is today the day? And don't get me wrong. I was thrilled. I was so excited. I was driving a BMW convertible at the time. And my wife and I were building this big honking mansion of a house. And dude, I was floored at the idea of walking into my boss's office and firing him in a nice, polite way. They had been good to me, but I was done. When I actually quit, it was seriously one of the happiest moments of my life. And I don't want to take that away from me. And I don't want to take that away from you. But the next day I woke up feeling not very different and saying, now what? And that shocked me. Having more money didn't actually change as much as I thought that it would. A few months later, I was on a beach in Jamaica, a small little island called Kokomo with my wife. We were celebrating being retired, which sounds really weird, but 27 years old, don't need to have a job anymore, living life on my terms. And something was still itching inside, something was still missing. Money had actually not brought what I thought that it would. It was true now that my behaviors were different, I didn't have to show up at a job, but I was really surprised and I wouldn't figure out the answer all the way for years. When I went on a humanitarian trip with my family to Africa, we had stockpiled a whole pile of money and we had gone to Africa to do, we were gonna help build an orphanage and we were doing a clean water project. And we were out there and we were having all of these really amazing moments. I was with this one family, this woman in their culture, they've been taught not to show their emotions. This woman had been widowed. She had, I think, 7 kids, and we brought her a cow. And in this part of the world, a cow is a business. A cow is food. A cow is milk. A cow will put your kids through school because the only option is a paid education. And when we gave her this cow, she had this just stone brick face, and the tears were streaming, but she was trying so hard not to cry. And I was just trying to understand, what's the meaning of this? And then the next day we went over to the school to bring them a bunch of school supplies. And after we had finished like giving them all these donations and building, planting trees and giving them school supplies and everything that they needed, this little black boy came out and he presented me with a gift. It was, well, I've got it. Let me show you. This little boy presented me with a ball that he had made. This ball is made from recycled or just grocery bags, I guess. And this plastic twine that's just kind of wrapping it all together. And he gave this to me as a ball that I could play with. And I had my family with me And I had some of my friends that had helped me put this whole project together. And then the master of the school came up to me and he said this. He said, "What we lack in resource, we make up for in creativity." And I'll tell you something, spending weeks with the poorest people on the planet, I never saw so many happy people. People way happier than we are here in the States. People that were content, people that find joy where they can find joy. They don't derive meaning the way we do from achievement per se or from having things. It's just such a different way of life that they have there from where we have here. And we talk about this conversation of what makes happy. Friend, I want to tell you something. Buying this multi-million-dollar house, it brings me a lot of joy. I mean, I've got the most magical view out that window of the whole valley. And at bed, when all my windows are turned to the city and I see it light up at night, I'm inspired. I feel calm. I love the energy of this place. It's magical to me. And it costs money for this. Or I drive a really, 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 really nice car. And when the top's down and I'm just speeding, I love that feeling of just the wind in my hair. And I feel free. And this is what I want to share with you. The meaning of life, it isn't about what we have. It's about how we feel. And that's what took me so long to figure out. I mean, I made millions of dollars of real estate. I'm building more wealth than I've ever had before. But what impact is that really having on my feelings? This is where life comes down to the art of fulfillment. And fulfillment comes down to meaning. What is the meaning in your life? I'm going to tell you right now, I can look back on my journey with my wife. When I was poor, when I had no money, when I was struggling, when I felt beat down, I felt like no one supported me. The reality is I had some amazing happy moments in my life at that time. And in Africa, I had amazing happy moments. And being wealthy, amazing happy moments. Doing charitable work every month with my wife and our foundation brings me happiness. You know what the weird thing is? The opportunity for happiness was always abounding. It was always available. I find it with raising my children during some of the moments. I find it doing really simple things. I find it in yoga, or I find it in working out at the gym or praying and meditating. I'm amazed. I really thought that all this money would change so much. And in the end, all it was going to do is magnify my soul. So friend, listen, if you want to be in the journey of creating wealth with me, awesome. Let's do it. Because I think that there's a yearning inside to meet our potential. And when we live beneath it, we feel like we're missing out. And I think we are. I feel like the purpose of this life, everyone's trying to figure out what that is for me. It's growth. When I am growing, I'm happy. And when I'm happy, I feel fulfilled. I guess if I could take this whole conversation all over the place and hone it into one way for you, is for me, happiness comes down to feeling. And I'm responsible for my feelings. I'm responsible for all my emotions. I can't believe I used to make myself as sad as I used to be, or to feel as bad as I used to feel, or feel shame or guilt about this. When the reality is, every opportunity there's negativity abounding, there's an equal opportunity for happiness. Do you have the ability to find it? If you want to build wealth with me, I'm going to tell you this. The person that knows how to control their feelings and their emotions and learn how to be happy now, regardless of when or how they build wealth, that's a person that has the ability to have the real wealth of life now. For what really is wealth? It's not money. If you need a thing outside of you to make you happy, then you're lost. But you can find yourself again. In the next 5 minutes, I want to challenge you when this video is over to just pause and find something real simple in your life that can bring you joy or happiness or peace. It's your life. Those emotions are your choice. And you know what? It's true. Having money opens more opportunities, more doorways. And my favorite thing to do with money has been the experiences that I've been able to afford. I've been able to travel to 40 different countries. I'm on my journey with my wife of hitting 100 different countries. I want to see the whole world. But with this money, there's a stewardship there where I get to do so many cool, amazing things. And I'm just telling you, you don't have to have money to feel that way now. Some of us are saying, "Kris, I want to do charity work like you. I want to be rich so I can give more." I'm telling you right now, you don't have to wait to be rich. A massive gift is not more meaningful than a small gift. Every one of us has a way to give back today. Every one of us today has the ability, you and I, to make an impact and make a difference in someone's life. I guess if you really want to be happy, yeah, you can click the link below. you can get with me and my team. I'll show you how I technically build wealth. And it's just textbook. It's awesome. I'll mentor you. I'll work with you. I'll show you how to do it. But don't do it hoping that it will make you happier. The happiness you're looking for is available right now, and it's just one choice away. So make that choice right now and start living your life today as if you were a billionaire, because your feelings, it doesn't have to be any different. But I do believe that happier people get more, have more, do more, and experience more. So the real wealth, happiness, joy, meaning, fulfillment, that's something that we have, all of us, within our grasp right now. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Appreciate you so much. Thanks for allowing me to get vulnerable and just share some of my personal feelings on something where I see so many people lost sheep, trying to find their way, thinking that money will do something. You don't have to wait decades to figure out that the wealth you're looking for truly is available now. There's so many poor people that's how they die, and they live a fantastic, great life. And I know a lot of rich people that die miserable. So it really has nothing to do with what you got. And if you're in the pursuit of trying to figure out, how do I elevate my life standards, my lifestyle, if you'd like to have more opportunities to travel around the world or to give more, then you got to get a handle on money and finance, and I can help you with that. So click the link, get with me and my team. We'll help you on that journey too.